you're talking about, but it still doesn't really highlight the types of actions that may be taken pursuant to this authority. And you could have, you know, shall include but not be limited to, or something like that. It just will allow everyone to view whatever action is authorized to say, well, where did they pull this from? And anyway.
Chair Finley, I want to clarify too. I mean, this situation, the other criteria would still have to be in place where, you know, there are no known attractants, they're complying with everything previously, and the use of non-lethals were ineffective. So indeed, those criteria would still be in place.
Why don't we put it in there? I mean, it's very difficult for people in their mind to reference a different section. And when you're talking about something as controversial as this may be or may not be, it's sometimes nice to have it just stated again. Someone on the first panel suggested we ask you about what the estimated mortality for 2017 was versus the actual.
For the record, Dr. Darren Clark, Wildlife Research Project here, Chair Finley. We have not yet estimated those numbers since we have not conducted our 2017 wolf counts, so we do not have final numbers on what our actual wolf population is. We'll look into those numbers as soon as we have our final data for 2017.
But didn't you have a projection of what you expected might occur in 2017 versus what we saw?
Chair Finley, we do have. From using population models, we could come up with projections what the population should have done or a range of scenarios that could occur. We could make that projection, but like I said, at this time, we do not have our actual 2017 population estimate to compare that to.